running through it with the young influence. Adolescent presence, I'm succumbing to it. I've been giving yeses when I shouldn't do it. I complete ejected with the moves and loser. And I'm barely moving, but I'm still gonna boost them. I can't work on winnings when I know you're losing. So I went to win.
And today we're gonna be ranking Logic's discography, more specifically his albums, not the mixtapes, not any of the Young Sinatra mixtapes, not any of the Bobby Tarantino mixtapes. This is gonna be solely strictly on the seven, yes I said seven albums, because I'm including Supermarket in this list, because even Logic and Visionary Music Group themselves said that Supermarket is the fifth studio album. So I'm including Supermarket in the ranking list. So without further ado, let's get it started. Number seven, right out the gate, Confessions in Dangerous Mind is the worst. We're gonna go from worst to best, and Confessions in Dangerous Mind is the worst, in my opinion. Collectively, as an album, I believe it is the worst. There's bangers. The title track, Lost in Translation, which I believe is a top 15 track, Lost in Translation. But like, overall, it's a complete package as an album. It's a whole lot of misses. Like, when I think about this album, I think about all the tracks I gotta skip. Wannabe, Clickbait, Out of Sight, Part of My Ego, It Depends on the Mood, Commando, I'm skipping that, Icy, I'm skipping that, Still Ballin' is a solid track, Cocaine, Could Have Been So Much Better, skipping that, Limitless, I love Limitless, Limitless is good, Keanu Reeves, I'm skipping that, Don't Breathe Free to Be Different, skip, Bobby, which I believe is one of Logic's worst songs ever, I'm definitely skipping that. So it's just like, I have the album, I'm just like, I'm automatically skipping, I can't listen to the whole album all the way through. Like, every time I listen to that album, I'm thinking to myself, I'm skipping this track. Next up, we got right above Confessions in Dangerous Mind is Supermarket. Supermarket is, in my opinion, better than Confessions in Dangerous Mind because it's collective as an album. It seems like one. You know, it's an alternative album from Logic. It's Logic's take on a rock album, per se. It's more alternative. It has some trap elements, some rap elements, because you know it's Logic. You're going to have some kind of elements of other genres in his music. And collectively, it sounds as a whole, but it's just like, it includes a lot of things that references the past, and you know, a lot of songs that, like, oh, this is an Outkast song, this is a track that's been done in the past. So it's like, it's not unique, but it's Logic's take on stuff. Supermarket. Supermarket has one of Logic's worst tracks, Lemon Drop. Lemon Drop is just, that track is just so bad. So right above Confessions in Dangerous Mind, Supermarket, and the reason for that is that Supermarket collectively is more of a better project than Confessions in Dangerous Mind. Next up in the fifth spot we have is Everybody. Problem with Everybody is just that it could have been executed so much better. You know, people clown on this album because Logic talk about his race so much, which I believe is not true. There's only a handful of tracks to talk about his race, but just like so many elements he could have done better. Like the track Take It Back, if he would have rapped Take It Back like he did the Under Pressure long extended track, that track could have been so much better. He did that beat wrong. He did that beat so wrong. 1-800, even though it was, I think it's seven times platinum now, it could have been better lyrically, but if it's a hit song, you can't go wrong with that. But it was just like many elements of the album that could have been executed so much better. Of the storyline with Neil deGrasse Tyson and Adam, just lackluster. It just felt like it was thrown in there last minute. Like, it felt like it could have been done so much more. So that's why Everybody's in my fifth spot. Next up, the list is getting better and better though. We got Young Sinatra 4. Man, I thoroughly enjoy Young Sinatra 4. I listen to the album at least once a week because it's just like, even though it doesn't have the true essence of the original Young Sinatra mixtapes, I think it just trying to reinvigorate what it used to have. Logic still had some of the best bars, some of the best flows on there. And like, yes, it has some tracks like Ordinary Day can be throwaway. One Day is definitely an automatic skip for me, but like a lot of those tracks, Everybody Dies, The Return, Wu-Tang Forever, the whole Wu-Tang Clan on a track? Only Logic can do that. Iconic Jada Smith with his two line. Logic did Jada Smith dirty on that. But he did come back with a hard-hitting second verse on Iconic. But yo, Sinatra 4, man, you know, it's not the best in terms of Logic projects, but it's just like, it got some tracks here and there. You just like, yeah, this is it right here. This is Logic, definitely this element. So Young Sinatra 4 comes in at my fourth spot with Logic's best albums. Next up, at number three, we have the recently released No Pressure. No Pressure, man, just the sequel to Under Pressure, the bars, the raps, the references to Kanye, J. Cole. You know, it's just Logic's returning to the element that he was and under pressure and just revigorating, like, okay, I understand that the flack I got from Supermarket, Fetches Ninja's Mind, all the previous projects they released since Under Pressure and Tits, et cetera, et cetera. So it's just like, this is me returning my form, this is me going to rap, this is me going to spit, get everything my all. I'm going to get as much samples as I possibly can from Outkast to Kanye West. I'm going to get everything I possibly can to make this the best project as I retire, which I truly believe he's not. He's retiring, but I think he's gonna come back in 3 to 5 years with supplies dry. Maybe it's Ultra 85. He says no pressure, it's supposed to be Ultra 85, but that remains to be seen. It's neither here nor there. We just gonna have to wait and see what brings with Logic his future in music. He still says he's always creating music. He's always still inspired, so it's gonna be interesting to see where he goes from here, but no pressure. Number three. Number two, we got the incredible true story and transformation of the man that saved the world. I put this above No Pressure because it's more complete of a project. You know, just outside the music, it just has so much more, from the skits to the production and the sound effects. It just has so much more that No Pressure has. It's more of a complete package. It's more cohesive because there's so much content. Like, if you turn off all the music, you got the skits, which is funny, hilarious, make a cohesive story, talk about space and time travel and social beings and stuff like that, and then the production on that, amazing. Just not just outside from the production, but just having different sound effects, ad libs added on to the project, and just collectively as a whole, like, outside the music, it's just a complete package that offers so much more than No Pressure does. So number two, I have The Incredible True Story and Transformation of the Man That Saved the World. And last but not least, my number one spot I have is, of course, Under Pressure. I think we all can agree this is a certified classic by Logic. There's no other project he could probably beat with Under Pressure. You know, No Pressure comes almost close. You know, it's currently my third spot. It comes so close, but Under Pressure, man, his bars, talking about his come up to be who he is, man, all the sufferings, the pain he went through and still persevered to be who he wanted to be, which is an icon, inspire others to do what they love. And Under Pressure, man, It just holds so much dear in my heart. I would just remember, I think it was sophomore, junior year when that project came out. And it just, man, if there's just one project I'm gonna just listen to until the day I die, it's definitely Under Pressure. It's nothing that can beat me for that. It's nothing that can top me for that. Now, some people don't call it a classic. I call it a classic. We can all agree that it's Logic's the best project, but I call Under Pressure a classic. That project just hit so well, and that's just Logic's best body of work. He probably could never beat it, but he can come close, man. As long as he keep working hard, keep pushing, come up with new ideas, he can top Under Pressure. But Under Pressure, man, no matter how many times I listen to it, it just feels so good, feels so great. So that is my top list of Logic's discography, ranking his albums from worst to best. At worst, we got Confession of Nature's Mind. At the best, we got Under Pressure. And tell me what you know. Tell me what your list is in terms of Logic's albums. And we're not talking about the Bobby Tarantino mixtapes or the Young Sinatra mixtapes. That's for another time. That's for another video. Just let me know, what do you rank Logic's cutter albums? Do you count Supermarket as an album? You know, some people call it a soundtrack. It doesn't count. Logic originated music group themselves says album, so that's why I counted it. And just let me know what you feel, how much you think about my list. Put your list down in the description down below, and let's have a conversation. So, if you like the video, please like the video. I got more content like this always coming soon. So please, subscribe. Let's see you next video. Peace.